So to do soft clustering, we're going to use a similar trick to what we've used in some of the other lectures, which is to lean on probability theory so that now points, instead of coming from one cluster or another cluster, can be probabilistically from one of multiple possible clusters. Does that seem like a good idea?
It does. I feel a song coming on. Lean on probability when you're not strongly believing one thing. No, that doesn't work.
That almost worked.
Almost.
Yeah. So that's because it's soft clustering or soft assignments instead of hard ones.
I like it.
All right. So to do this, we're going to have to connect up a probabilistic generative process with the data that we actually observe. So let's assume, and there's many ways to go down this road, but we're going to go down the road this way. Assume that the data was generated by, what happens is we're going to select one of k possible Gaussian distributions. So we're going to imagine that the data is going to be generated by draws from Gaussians, from normals.
Mm-hmm.
Let's assume that we know the variance, sigma squared, and that the k Gaussians are sampled from uniformly.
Okay.
And then what we're going to do is, given that Gaussian, we're going to select an actual point, an actual data point in the space from that Gaussian. And then we repeat that n times. So if n is bigger than k, then we're going to see some points that come from the same Gaussian. And if those Gaussians are well separated, they're going to look like clusters.
Assuming they have very different means.
All right. That's what I mean by well separated. Yeah, exactly so.
Yeah. Okay, good.
All right. And in particular, what we'd like to do now is say, all right, well, now what we're really happening is we're given the data. We're thinking kind of Bayesianly, right? We're given the data, and we want to try to figure out what the clusters would have been to have generated that data. So we're going to try to find a hypothesis, which in this case is just going to be a collection of k means, not to be confused with k means, that maximizes the probability of the data, right? So find me k mu values, which are the means of those Gaussian distributions, so that the probability of the data given that hypothesis is as high as possible. And this is an ML hypothesis, and ML, of course, stands for Michael Littman.
I don't think that's right.
Machine learning.
That's closer, but not quite right.
Maximum likelihood.
That I think is correct.
All right. So that's now the problem set up. I didn't actually give you an algorithm for doing this, but presumably it's going to depend on various kinds of things in probability theory and optimization. But is it sort of clear what we're shooting for now?
It is. And I actually think the fact that we're looking for k-means probably means that we are going to end up tying it back to k-means.
Maybe so, but again, it's a softer kind of k-means. It's a softer, gentler kind of k-means.
Mm.
I think some people call it k-Gaussians. Does that sound right?
No.
All right, then.
I mean, it sounds correct, but it doesn't sound right.
All right, then.